Hey, this is Lisa Allen, and in this video you will learn how to do simple editing of your video using Camtasia. Now, even if you already have some other application to edit videos, a lot of the features will be similar, so you will still learn about video editing in general from this video. So first we'll talk a little bit about the interface of Camtasia so you understand what you're looking at. And this that we're looking at on the screen is Camtasia, and you can see that we have a preview window of the video we're working on here in the right. And you can watch your video in progress and the results of your edits here. On the left, there are some tabs, and this tab in the first is called the clip bin, and this contains the elements we will use in the finished video. You can see here that I have a video clip and an image in my clip bin for this project. To get other elements into the clip bin, you can just click on File, Import Media, and then select a file to import. If you used Camtasia to record the screen, the recording will already be in the clip bin when you save and edit the recording. There is also a library tab, and the library tab contains some stock theme elements such as title screens and also some music that you can add to your videos. Now, the selection of the music is not great, but it is free to use in your videos. Next, we have the Callouts tab. These are standard pieces that you can put in your video, like arrows and notes. And you can see that we have a lot of different types here. Incidentally, if you ever want to blur out a part of your video to hide a password or something else, you can use the Blur Callout down here in the Special section. Now, this is the Audio tab, which is where you'll be able to adjust parts of the audio levels and remove noise. And transitions are used to move from one clip to another with a special effect of some sort. Most of these transitions that they include are overkill, so I would stick with the simpler ones. You don't really want your video to look like a bad 1980s music video. So fade and fade through black are the ones that I use most often. And if you just double click the transition, you can get a preview of what it looks like. And below the tabs, we have the timeline area, and this is where you can add elements to your video or trim pieces out. But before we get started editing a video, I want to remind you to always, always save your project first, and to make sure that you save it from time to time as you're working. It's really no fun to redo your work if something bad happens on your computer and your project crashes. Now, Camtasia 8 is fairly stable, but I did have this happen to me on Camtasia 7 a few times, so always be careful and save your project. So the first thing you generally want to do when you start working on your video is to drag your clip from the clip bin down onto the timeline. And the first time you do this, it will give you this dialog and ask you how big you want your video to be. Generally, it suggests 854 to 480 to you, but I usually change that to 1280 by 720 because I want an HD video. And don't worry if you don't drop your video clip exactly where you wanted. You can also drag it around on the timeline with the mouse very easily. You'll also notice that we have different tracks here. Tracks are sort of like layers on your video. The layers at the top will obscure the layers at the bottom, as you might expect. So if I add an arrow or a note to my video, it goes to the next highest track, so it will display over the base video as it plays. Now, another thing that I want to have you really pay attention to is the sound graph at the bottom. And you can see that the sound has a visual representation here. And you want to see how there are some gaps. These are places that you'll want to take a look at editing out of your video. So perhaps I made a mistake at this point and paused and then redid that section, or maybe I was moving to the next element into place on my presentation. But by looking at the audio track, it's very easy to see where you might need to trim pieces out. So let's first trim out the front of the video, because you can see there was a little bit of a pause before I started talking. And if the part that you want to trim out is very small, sometimes you may even need to use the zoom on the controls here above the timeline to make that part a little bit bigger so you can see where to trim. And the playhead is right here on the timeline, so to select the part to clip out, just drag the end markers of the playhead. Then you want to press Ctrl X on the keyboard to cut that piece out. Now, one thing that many professionals clip out as well is the sounds of their breathing, and I do this if they are really noticeable. Breaths tend to always look like a short, low-level curve on the graph. So let me just find one for you so you can see what they look like. This is a breath here, and if I change the zoom back down to normal, you can kind of see that they all look the same. So these little areas here, like that would be a breath there, and there's another one here and another one there. So they're really, really easy to spot on the timeline, and you can just use that, just visually zoom in on them and get rid of them very, really quickly. So now, just for an example, let's add a call out to the video. So just switch over to the Callouts tab, and you can see all the choices if you just click the down arrow there. And even though we have a whole bunch of things we could do, I'm just going to choose an arrow for a demonstration. And if you click on it, you can see that Camtasia drops it on the timeline here, and it also drops it into the preview window. And you can drag the callout around to position it in the window. You can drag the side handles to resize it, make it larger or smaller. And you can also use the rotation handle to change where it points and its angle. And you can also see on the timeline that it can have a fade in and a fade out. And the way you change the length of the fade in or fade out or get rid of it is by dragging the sliders or putting a time in the seconds box. So if I wanted to take out the fade in, I would just put a zero there, and you see now that the fade in is gone. Now, I mentioned transitions before, and transitions are really great for moving from one type of screenshot to another, such as between slides on your presentation. So you can see here is the point where my slides shift, and so I'm just going to cut out this big empty space, and I could add a transition here just by dragging it down into the splice point or onto the end. And if I move the playhead, you can see how it dims down to black and then brings the other one in. So that's what that particular transition looks like. Now let's go to the audio tab for a moment. One thing you almost always want to do is to go into the audio tab and check the enable noise removal box. This will get rid of most of the room noise from the recording, though usually it won't deal with a severe echo problem. Also on the audio, you can adjust the levels of the audio by clicking the volume up and volume down buttons. But always try to record at a reasonable level though, because the more you have to boost the levels this way in the video editing, the more random noise will end up in the finished video in the background. Now I have one last little trick to show you, and this is one that I had to really hunt for information to find out how to do, and that is to animate elements on the screen. Now let's say that I have this element which is just sitting here, and I would like to move this element across the screen instead of it just sitting here. Guess what? You actually can do that with Camtasia, but the feature is sort of hard to get to because it's hidden. So to get to it, just click on the More tab and then click on Visual Properties. Select the element that you want to move or animate on the timeline. So if I wanted to move this element, say from over here, and move it down here, what I would do would be to move the playhead to the point where I want the animation to end. So if I wanted it to end, I would move the playhead there, click on Add Animation, and you can see now that the element has a visual animations tray on the bottom of it with the animation displayed here. So now that I am in the edit animation, I would just move it over to where I want it to end. And then to edit how long the animation takes to perform that action, I would just drag the end. So perhaps I wanted it to start from when the element first appeared on screen and go all the way to right before it started to fade out. So let's just show you what that animation looks like as we run through it with the playhead. And you can see that it moves over there and then fades out. And of course, you can add multiple animations to a single element on the screen to do more complicated things following the same steps. So once you have finished editing your project, be sure to save it again. And then the last step is to turn it into an MP4. So click on the Produce and Share button, and you can see here that there are different types of files that you can produce. I usually choose the MP4 only in the 720p size because I'm going for an HD size video. And then you just click Next. Give the file a name, choose where you want to save it, and click on Finish. And once you've done that, Camtasia will render the video into a playable file for you. So that's it for this tutorial on basic video editing using Camtasia. And in the next video in this series, I'll go over how to upload your video to YouTube and search optimize it. So thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this video or have comments on it, please share those in the comment box below.